All right, good evening, everyone. Thanks so much for coming out tonight on a rainy night. That was the Nutcracker Overture, maybe not the one that you were expecting. Tchaikovsky wrote the Nutcracker in 1892. In 1916, American arranger for the Ellington Band, Billy Strayhorn, arranged and reorchestrated that version for tonight. Tonight's program is called Danzo, which means dance. It's a style of dance common in Veracruz and in Cuba. The name of our program comes from our last piece. Orchestra, the word orchestra in the original Greek root actually means dance or place for dancing. So I think we're in the right place here tonight. We're going to be doing music that addresses the tradition of dance in the Americas. So that was an American jazz interpretation of Russian ballet. We're also going to be taking some music from Mexico, African-American dances from the early 20th century, and the music of Florence Price. All this music has origins all around the world and comes together in an incredible way, in a unique way, here in American dance music. Before we go that direction, however, we have some wonderful soloists to perform with us tonight. We have three young artist competition winners, with our Petri students, to perform tonight. Actually, the Nutcracker, Tchaikovsky's Nutcracker, was based on a libretto, or based on a story written by E.T.A. Hoffman, a famous, famous surrealist author, who also was the source of the narratives for a play, an opera by Jacques Offenbach, Tales of Hoffman. In this opera, the fictionalized version of Hoffman tells three love stories. He's sitting around in a bar and people ask him to tell about his three great loves. And so the first love, Hoffman, the fictional Hoffman, falls in love with a mechanical doll named Olympia. And everyone else around Hoffman knows that Olympia is a doll, except Hoffman, who has been sold some magical glasses that means he can't really see her for who she is. So here to perform the Olympia's Doll aria, we have our first soloist and Young Artist Competition winner, Madeline Owens.
Thank you.
And there's actually more than that in the program. That's not the end of the show. All right, our next wonderful soloist is going to be taking us in a very different direction. We have Sydney Stevens on the oboe, our junior Bachelor of Music in Music Therapy on the oboe. Alessandro Marcello was a Venetian composer from a very important period associated with Vivaldi, with his brother Benedetto Marcello. This is the very famous and very, very beautiful adagio from the Oboe Concerto by Alessandro Marcello, Sydney Stevens. right. For our third and final Young Artist Competition winner for this evening, we have a really fantastic piece, the Clarinet Concerto No. 2, E-flat Major, by Carl Maria von Weber. This piece was written in 1811 for Heinrich Behrmann, who was a pioneering clarinet player of the time, or virtuoso, who actually was responsible for a lot of the really incredibly virtuosic flourishes and improvisational character of the solo part in this piece, collaborating with Weber on this. For our fantastic performance, our final Young Artist winner for the evening, we have Lucien Liu.
Thank you.
I guess it wasn't such a far departure from dancing, actually, in those, some of those pieces. So our next piece is a really wonderful collection of pieces by Florence Price, great American composer of the late 19th, early 20th century, collected called Dances in the Cane Breaks. These pieces are African-American dances from sort of the pre-ragtime era, late 19th century, early 20th century African-American dance music, written by Price for the piano at the very, very end of her life. She wrote these in 1953, the year that she died, for the piano. After she died, the pieces were taken by the also eminent William Grant Still, American composer, and orchestrated in sort of Technicolor style. They're really wonderful orchestrations by Still. I'll be taking on the first two movements myself, and then we'll take a quick pause and welcome Alana Farmer to conduct the third movement.
Thank you.
Please welcome Alana Farmer, our assistant conductor. All right. And we get to round out our really wonderful program tonight with one of the most famous and fun, frankly, pieces written in Mexico in the 20th century. The Danzo number 2 was by Arturo Marquez, written 1994, early in the year during the Zapatista uprising, actually. Marquez was inspired by the ballroom dance in Veracruz in the eastern coastal region, not so far from Cuba, where the Danzo is the national dance. I looked into this a little bit. I was expecting kind of wild flourishes and kind of extravagant dancing, but actually the Danzo tradition, as you may know, I did not know, is more like the contra dance. It's a social dance. It's danced in a very stately and kind of organized way by people of all ages. And actually, it comes from contra danza, I guess. The tradition of contra dance comes through Spain, through Africa, all through Cuba, all through Latin America, in a pretty actually amazing in way. But this piece by Marquez is really a wonderful representation of danzo, which is characterized by really fantastic music, very virtuosic playing, solo expression, and just a good time. So before we turn our attention to our last piece, I'd like to just recognize one more time our fantastic soloists tonight, our Young Artist Competition winners. Thank you all for coming. You know, it's okay to wiggle in your seat if you're having a good time on this one. This is a party piece. So enjoy the last danzo.
Thank you.